It's been a while since I've gone live cooking because of my hectic schedule, but I am back. We no longer have rallies on Mondays. Our rallies were moved to Tuesdays, so I don't need to rush now on Mondays. So let me know if my sound is okay. I had to adjust this because I used it for something else recently, and so I had to make some adjustments to sound and the brightness and stuff. So I just want to make sure that you guys can hear me okay and you guys can see me okay. Here we go. Hi, Blake. Hi, Sheena. Hi, Jackie. Hi, Tammy. Hi, Margie. Okay, so let me know if you guys can hear me and if the color is bright enough so you can see everything. I tried to brighten it. I am going to go live on Instagram for a little bit. Not right now, but maybe later on, because Instagram is a little bit different. And I want to keep my focus on you guys when you guys comment. Hi, Maria. Hi, Sonia. I see you guys. Hi, Crystal. So I'm using the stack cooker because you guys know the stack cooker is the promotion this month. So, and I haven't used this on a regular just because I've been doing other things and I don't really think about it. But I haven't gone grocery shopping in a while. Hi, Lori. Hi, Jessica. And so thankfully, this stack cooker cookbook, I got to tell you guys, I didn't think I would be using this as much as I have been lately. And it could just be like my mindset, because my mind is thinking this is like American different kinds of cooking and not really local cooking. Hi, Sherry. Hi, Christina. And so I was just flipping through it because I haven't gone grocery shopping, so I don't have a lot of groceries to really use for making dinner. Oh my God, Emily, seriously? Hold on a minute. Okay, I need to put this away and I need you to get out of the kitchen, okay? I'm trying to cook here. And so I've literally been scrounging my pantry to figure out what the heck I'm going to make for dinner, because this is what we have. And we're not doing the keto life. We're not going to really change our diets back to what we were. So we have been picking up some weight, as you guys can probably see. But we're going to kick it off on Saturday. So right now what I'm trying to do is just use what I have, because it's after the holiday season. Everybody is a little bit penny pinching, yeah, with their budget. So we have a bunch of potatoes. We have a lot of potatoes we need to use up, and I don't want to waste it simply because of a diet change right now. Like, we need to eat potatoes, you know what I'm saying? So we have potatoes. I had steak. Koshobi bought steak, so I defrosted that. We have onions. We have quinoa. I actually have like this quinoa rice blend that I'm using. Hi, Marie. So we're going to use this because I don't want to use like all rice and I don't have just plain quinoa. And so I was flipping through this. Originally, I was going to do steak with like gravy or something. And I just decided to flip through this to see what would be in here that I could make with my stack cooker using what I have in my kitchen. And so just so happens they have things for me. So I was flipping through the bottom. So at the bottom, we're going to do the quinoa. The middle, we're going to do steak and onions. And on the top, we're going to do herbed potatoes. Doesn't that sound good? Now, this is with using things that I just happen to have in my kitchen without having to go to the grocery store. So I'm really excited. I'm also nervous because, again, I'm using recipes and I'm not good with recipes. I tend to like screw things up all the time when I have to follow instructions. So let me get the chicken broth out, because it says 3 cups of chicken broth. But I'm going to have to wing it because the recipe uses quinoa and I'm using like quinoa rice. This is Christine's potato counters. I don't know if these are Idaho potatoes. They're from Costco. So I've already peeled 2 really big potatoes. These are huge potatoes, so I didn't want to like peel too many of them. But I'm going to do that one last. So right now they're sitting in water so that they don't turn brown. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to do the quinoa rice for the box. Actually, no, I take that back. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to cut up the steak. So it says to use 1 pound of cubed steak. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I don't know if cube steak means that's the name of the steak or if it means you cube the steak. So forgive me for not knowing proper terminology. If Aisha is watching, I think she works in the meat department at Costco, she probably could tell me. So let me just rinse the steak off. I'm just going to take one of these steaks because these are big. The dinosaur ones you saw the other night. Okay, so. Right? I got to read the recipe twice. I'm actually just using it as a guide and then I'm going to wing it. So I'm just going to cut these into smaller chunks, I guess. There's no, like, it's not brain surgery. And if Romel is trying to text me right now, sorry, I can't see your messages. I don't know where he is. He's usually home by now, but he ain't. So I don't know where he's at. So I'm going to use the bottom of the snap cooker. That's the 3-quart one at the bottom. The picture shows like huge chunks of meat. So I'm just going to cut them in chunks. And you know, I find when you cut them in smaller cubes, they're a little bit more tender. But this recipe uses vinegar. And the reason is the vinegar helps to tenderize the meat. So I'm just cutting these in chunks. So when you're stack cooking stuff, you do have to cook it for, depending on how many stacks you have, you do have to cook it for a little bit longer. So disclaimer, this video is going to be at least 30 minutes long. Because when I do these, like when I've been doing pressure cooker ones, I've been like coming on when it's done and you guys don't see the prepping part. And it's been a while since I did one where I did it start to finish with you guys so that it's like real time cooking. The name of the steak is... It just says SS boneless chuck steak. That's it. That's all it says. So I'm just using this. So I'm just cutting it in like squares. Like this. This is about a pound. And then it says to add vinegar and oil and rub the steaks with the seasoning. So you can use whatever seasoning you want. Cube is just a tenderized steak. Oh. I don't think this one's a tenderized one, but the vinegar should do that. Let me wash my hands. I was handling all this meat. So it says to take a 1/4 cup of white vinegar with, it says adobo with pepper seasoning. I don't know where you would get that because Filipinos make our own adobo mixture. It says to use ground annatto. I don't have that. Garlic cloves and a small onion. So we're going to wing this. I'm going to use a little bit of white vinegar. That I do have. It says 1/4 cup, but holy smokes, that sounds like a lot of vinegar, don't you think? Let me get my 1/4 cup. If I can find it. This is 1/3. I'm just not going to fill it all the way up. So I'm using 1/3 cup and pouring that on top. And then a little bit of olive oil. That I do have here. So I'm just going to drizzle a little olive oil. I am going to get back in here with my hands because I want to rub it real good. I want to rub this meat up, you know. Okay. I'm not ignoring your comments. I am reading your comments. I'm trying to stay focused. I don't mess this, jam this thing up. So what I'm going to use is the, because this is my favorite seasoning, honestly, for steak. So I'm going to use this. Hi, Joanna. We're doing a stack cook meal today. So I'm just going to sprinkle this on the meat using my hands because I want to crumble it up all over the top. This is going to be like as basic and simple as it gets. Too many ingredients, they kind of like throw me off a little bit. Hi, Kristen. Okay. So I just use that and I'm also going to put a little bit of pepper on here. And then I'm going to slice up the onion and hopefully not cry my eyes out on live again. And garlic. Okay, so I'm going to slice. Well, let me do the garlic first. Let me rinse this off. This has like meat blood juices in it. My mom is here. She just showed up. And she gave the baby a bath because she just pooed. Like while I was trying to get ready for all this. So let me just smush the garlic. Oh, sorry. I keep forgetting that you guys are attached to my counter. Okay, garlic. I'm just using 2 cloves because these are pretty fat cloves of garlic. Okay. I'm just going to chop it up. I don't want to... Today, I'm just going to do it like right now kind of thing. Hi, Raina. Hi, Vaughn. I'm not going to take out any special extra gadgets because... I don't feel like it. You guys know how the chopping prep works, right? If I was doing like 5 or 6, then maybe, but this is just 2 cloves, so it's all good. This is, it smells good already. Okay, now I'm gonna do an onion. So I'm prepping, this is Maria. This was supposed to go in the middle, but that's okay. It's gonna be okay, guys. It's gonna be okay. I put this in the bottom by accident. I was supposed to do the quinoa there and I realized I put it in the wrong thing. But I'm not going to cook too much quinoa because Ramel's not a big fan of that. He'll probably just eat this with potatoes. And I wish I had gone to the store and bought goggles for slicing onions. Hi, Darcy. Thank you. Hi, Susan. Okay, so we're winging it. I'm right now my brain is like thinking about, do I move this to the next casserole or not? Because I don't cook quinoa a lot, you guys. So if you guys cook quinoa, please tell me, would it be a better idea to move it around? Because does the, like, you know when you cook rice, the starch and stuff, it causes like boil over sometimes. Does that happen with quinoa or no? Because quinoa is a grain and not a starch. You know what I mean? But like, is it like pasta where it boils up? Like, I think I'm going to just move it just because that's what the instructions say to do. Because Lord knows when I don't follow it, things go all haywire. So I'm going to do this whole onion. This wasn't a very big onion. So I'm just slicing it. And I'm going to move it now before I jack something up again. So it comes with a colander piece. This is the 1 3/4 casserole. So I'm going to move the steak, the vinegar, the all of that stuff, and I'll wash this. Because this is where the quinoa is supposed to go. So let me just move this. I'll wash this out. Lord have mercy. Okay, now we're going to put the onions on top. And I'm going to massage everything together and quickly put the cover on before my eyeballs get all weepy. So I was watching... hi, Lori. Move it around. Yes, I agree, Jessica. So I'm just massaging everything in here. And I'm going to put the cover on. So this is the 1 3/4. And I'm going to throw this on so my eyes don't get all crazy on me. And then let me wash this. And tomorrow, I think I'm going to do pork chops because that's what I have defrosted. I was debating if I should do pork chops today. And oh, cripes, I'm wet. That beef thing in the stack cooker cookbook looked a lot more fun. So we're going to do that. Okay, let me just wash this out because it has oil and things in it. And drain that because now we're gonna do the bottom. So when you're cooking in the stock cooker, the cooking part is so quick and easy. It's the putting it together part, as just like cooking any other dish, is the part that kind of is trickier. Like it takes some logistical strategizing. Okay, so trying to use big words on you guys. Okay, so here is what goes on the bottom. So it says 1 1/2 cups of quinoa rinsed. Now this is quinoa and rice. So I'm hoping that this doesn't go all bento. I have a half cup measuring cup here. So this is, I can't remember. This was from, is that the mail lady? Hold on a minute. Is that the mailman? Is that the mailman? Oh. It's the husband. Okay, so half a cup went in. I have like boxes to give the mail lady. I left a note for her in the mailbox. 1 cup. Whoa. Half a cup. If I'm not mistaken, this was from Costco. I think my mom bought me this. 1 set of the Disney set. I'm not sure, Joey. Because it's a sample. Samples, you can only buy one, but you can always purchase additional at 25% off the sale price. So it's like black rice with quinoa. It's like a blend of healthy grains and things. So let me wash this out. And then it says to add 3 cups of chicken broth. So do you guys normally rinse quinoa? Like, I don't cook with this stuff. This is going to be interesting because I've not done this before. I think I did it like once or twice in the past. And to be honest, I don't remember what the outcome was. It must not have been devastating or I would have like 2,000 views on it. Okay, so I rinsed it. I kind of drained out as much water as I could.
What are you cooking?
I'm making that.
What is that?
Excuse you. Daddy, where's my can opener?
Dad, I'm feeling better.
Where?
Dad, I'm feeling better.
Over there, meaning where? Because I don't see it.
Oh, it's inside the dish rack.
Oh, Lord.
No comments? What?
What? It's up here.
Oh, since when you did that?
So the stand, Kristen, I found a place to actually hook it up, but it took some MacGyvering. But it worked. So thank you, Kristen, for my iPad holder. It took, you know why? The arm is hard to bend. So I was like, I don't know where I'm going to stick this thing. But as long as the wind doesn't gust in here, I think we're okay. Hi, Deanna. Hi, Liz. The camera's right here as usual. All I did was move this from here to up here. They said, hi, Ramel.
Spring break is from the 25th to the
29th. Hi, Tammy.
Well, I'm going to Disney World the 20th to the 24th.
Shelby's back at school.
Okay, so I'm opening my chicken broth. They all said, hi, Ramel.
Hello, Joanna.
March 25th to the
29th. Well, we're coming. We're going to be back already by then.
Oh.
Okay, so.
Never mind.
Are you guys going on a trip?
We're going to Disney World.
Disney World?
Whoopsie. Half.
When?
One.
Mm.
Half. Two-ish.
When is the trip?
Yeah, go Cowboys.
March 21. I don't want to open a whole other can of chicken broth just to add like half a cup of liquid. I'm going to add half a cup of water.
Hey, Deanna.
Okay, now what?
Sherelle.
Chicken broth and salt.
Margaret and Wendy, hi.
Yes, so look, everybody says hi. It says half a teaspoon of salt. Here's 1 teaspoon. We'll just do half. Okay, Tehim. Tehim. Okay, so I'm just going to go like this. Okay. Then we're going to stack this on top. See how that goes? Okay, so now we're going to do the top layer. How long have I been on? That's how long it's taking me to just put this together. So I was debating, do I go live while I do this or not? And, you know, during our training this past weekend, one of my new recruits, Elizabeth, she started by watching my videos. Yeah, 2.625. And she was telling me, like, she understands the whole... I'm supposed to be doing this as slices, but whatever. Okay, take potatoes, a little onion, water, butter, and basil or tarragon. And it, according to the picture, you're supposed to mandolin this and like slice it like that. But I already cut it, so I'm just going to go with this. Okay, guys, bear with me. Because I don't know what I'm doing. But she mentioned like... So, you know, my videos from a couple years ago have always been long, like at least 40 minutes, because my whole purpose and intent with doing these lives was to show you guys in real time how long it really takes me to get dinner done, not just, hey guys, I'm on and check this out, you know what I mean? And I started pulling away from that because I don't know if it was just me, but I just felt like, okay, this is taking too long. Maybe you guys are getting bored, and I started changing the way I was doing things, and I would just go on when it was ready to open. And when she mentioned that to me over the weekend, I was like, I think I need to take it back to that again. And like, you know, because I think a lot of people are looking for something to watch, number one, something to learn from, and also not feel like they don't know what they're doing either, because a lot of us don't know any. We're all in the same boat, so you don't feel so alone. So I just took 2 big potatoes and I sliced them up like this, nothing fancy. And I'm going to put, I'm not going to do the onion. There's a lot of onions in the steak. And if we're going to eat it together, that's a little oniony. It says 2 to 4 tablespoons of water. So I'm just going to take a little bit of water. Like, just a little. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how I measure. Do I have tarragon? I thought I did, because I swear. Is that what I used? That one thing on chicken, and it was like super yummy, and I'm like, I don't even know what this is. It's interesting to watch and learn. That's true, Sean, you're right. You're never bored with me. You guys are so sweet. Is this it? Is this tarragon? Okay, I don't think so. Let's just use oregano. Let's use oregano. I don't think that's tarragon. I think I'm out of tarragon. Okay, so how much oregano? 1/2 teaspoon. So you can use dried basil, dried oregano, or tarragon. I think I have basil. Which one should I use? Should I use oregano or basil? Because we are out of tarragon. Okay, I can't find basil. You know what would be good? That's a lot of onion. I'm going to try using some of this onion salt that Leanne sent me. We're going to go with oregano. So we're going to pinch it, sprinkle it. We're just going to go with it, guys. Okay. And I'm going to sprinkle some onion salt because I saw it right there. Wait, where's the open one? I have one that's open from Leanne. Okay, where is it? Did somebody take it? No. How about no? Okay, we're going to sprinkle onion salt. Oh, shucks, Malia. Hi, Ren. I just did the oregano. Some onion salt from Trader Joe's. This stuff is really, really good. If you guys have a Trader Joe's, I highly recommend it. Put it on everything. And some butter. And the butter we have, folks, is Country Crock. Where on earth is it? Back there. So, yeah, so when Elizabeth said that, I was like, I think I'm going to take it back to that again. Like, let's just take it back to where I started, where my whole intent was to show you guys what it really takes. Any regular mom with little kids, like, in real time, how much drama we go through just to get dinner done, you know? Not just, oh, here it is, it's all done. Sorry, I'm tapping. How much butter did it take? A tablespoon, yikes. Okay, so I put a tablespoon and a half of margarine. Okay, so we have our potatoes on top, our cube steak in the middle, and we have our rice and quinoa at the bottom with chicken broth and salt. Okay, so we're gonna put this in for 20 minutes and pray to Lord Jesus that it comes out, because I've never made it before. Actually, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with 15 because I don't wanna burn or kill anything. So while that's on, we get to talk story like we used to back in the olden days, you know, a couple years ago. So, and you know what I realized, you guys? I just cut one potato. Stop. Hammer time. I saw it in the sink. I'm like, wait, did I do two? Did you guys catch that? That I said two potatoes and I only cut one? Oh, you like when I talk story? Like when I do these? Where I talk too much and I forget what the hell I'm doing. Yeah. These are humongous potatoes. And I remember somebody just said this knife is really sharp. It is. This is a Tupperware knife. And you know what? I have not needed to sharpen this since I got this in October. And I use this every single day for everything. Stop. Hammer time. Let's put this on top because that's a lot for one potato. So you guys all caught that I said two potatoes and I only cut one. And nobody yelled and screamed at their phone, right? And said, stop, you didn't do it. I'm just going to throw it on top. I mean, gosh. It's not the end of the world, right? Let me put some more onion salt. Because onion salt is life. I swear you guys, this stuff is so good. And it makes it look pretty with the specks of green. It looks like, it reminds me of sour cream and onion chips. Okay. So let's put this back on. Press start. Here we go. GGO. So what I was actually thinking about making was, I was going through what I had in my pantry and I was like, okay, I have this. What do I do with this? How do I make this work? You know what I mean? Hi, Karina. And so my neighbor gifted us this and it's organic green bean fettuccine. So it's a pasta alternative. If you're doing keto, this is not a keto thing. It has 21 grams of carbs for when you use 2 ounces of it. However, it's very dense in nutrients. So depending on what your diet is all about, it says it's low carb, gluten free, high protein, high fiber. But I think 21 grams of carbs for 2 ounces is a lot. And there's 4 servings in here. So that's 2 times 4, 84 grams of carbs in this whole bag. See how fast they did that? I don't think that was common core math. So she gave us this. So I was going to do this. And then I thought, I'm doing like Holly food. And then the other thing she gave me was, Lord have mercy, where's the box? Right here. The other thing Zelda gave me was organic edamame spaghetti. I'm excited to try this thing. This one also has 21 grams of carbs in a 2-ounce serving, so it's not a low carb. I wouldn't consider that to be low. But it's non-GMO, organic, all that good stuff. There's my mom. So now we have to talk sorry because we have 15 minutes for that to cook. So what are we going to talk about? Ooh, I know what. Hashtag what you want to see my mom cook on my next on the next video. So you got to hashtag it. That way we can search it and find it for later. So everybody comment what you want my mom to cook next time. So one thing that somebody had asked me was sari sari. Somebody asked that. So somebody hashtag sari sari for me so I can go back and find it. What was the other thing?
I want to talk about something.
Mom, my friend has pigeon peas, that plant in Waianae. Yeah.
Mommy, can I?
And she said her neighbors don't cook that.
That's what I told her.
Kajus something. Kajus. Yeah, that's a Ilonggo thing. Look, they said pinakbet. Oh, my mom made pinakbet the last time, Cole.
Mom.
Yes.
Hi, Kel.
Hello. Happy New Year, you guys.
Can I talk about something?
Yes.
Today and the other nights, today we have we have a dead rat under our fridge.
Yes, we unfortunately...
And we always smell its poo-poo.
No, there's a... You know how you can smell...
The pancit with egg and chicharron.
Thank you, Emily, for sharing that with the world. We found a dead mouse in our kitchen.
What?
Yes, that's why I have the fan on. I didn't want Emily to tell the whole world that, but I'm sure we're not the only one that...
Pancit with egg.
Dead
with
animal.
Chicharron.
Daddy was trying to get the dead
what's
rat.
What's the pancit that you put the egg? Oh, egg and chicharron.
Yeah, that's the...
That's not palabok.
Palabok.
Yeah.
Hi, everybody.
You know what? So one of my extended family moms, I don't know how you would say it, but her secret ingredient to her pancit palabok is the Cheetos. Puffs. And you take 2 bags of puffs of Cheetos and you crumble it up and it makes that cheesy sauce. Get a cat. Daddy might shoot the cat. Sinigang. My mom hasn't made sinigang. I've made it a few times, Cole, in the pressure cooker, but it's been a while. Mario says, Magandang kang... Oh, Mario, you can speak Filipino. Stop!
Magandang hapon sa'yo, Mario.
Is it hapon? Tanghali. What is tanghali?
Afternoon.
Oh, Rach says, kare-kare. I did kare-kare, too, in the pressure cooker a long time ago. Malia lives in the country. See, we are not alone. So, there, I could... You know how you can smell it, and I'm like, okay... There's something not right in here, and we found it in the water tray underneath, you know, where the condensation and it drips into that drip pan thing underneath. And so Ramel took it out, but he didn't take out the whole pan and wash it, so yeah, so he's gonna have to do that today and clean it out because I can't deal with this. But I'm glad we got rid of it, because you know how what's the worst is when it's in your walls and you can't get to it and you have to live with that smell until it's like beyond gone and turn into dust. That's like the worst. And I know I'm not the only one.
Bella, where are you? Here I am. Here I am. How do you feel?
So wait, Emily goes back to school tomorrow.
When mommy...
Yuck is right, Asriel.
When Christine goes on the... On the iPad, she finds this video on YT Kids, and then he's like, what is this? Orange.
Oh, squid guisado. Yeah, Mom, make that. That's Mitchell's favorite.
And
Mom, make squid guisado.
And in the beginning...
She said she can do that next week. Hi, Shelly. Say hi, Uncle Mario.
In the beginning, she says this. Let's learn... Root and vegetables. Then he starts saying, what is this? And then she says the fruit name.
Uh-huh.
Mommy says that.
Mm-hmm.
And she's telling me to play the
video. I was following it and nobody knew what I was talking about when he goes, what is this? Orange. Very good. What is this? Tomato. Very good. What is this? Like that. That's how he sounds. Yes, for school. Oh, they went back already. Oh, you want to know how the squid guisado is made? You'd be surprised how simple it is, Cole. I mean, for real. It's like really, really simple. The hardest part is cleaning the squid, and I hate that part because it's like all up in your fingers. You got to use lemon to get rid of that smell. Okay, can you go now? Where's Daddy?
I don't know.
Okay, move. Go to Mama. She's watching the video over there. Go. Go. Thanks. Okay, so Shelby went home on Friday and she tried to pack some foods with her and she didn't have a check bag. She was doing a carry-on and she tried to bring Lily Koi butter with her. And she should have asked me first because I would have told her they won't allow this because it's a liquid and it's also not 3 ounces, it's 8. So she had to take this out of her bag. She couldn't take it. So that means Lily Koi butter for me. We're supposed to ship it, but that didn't happen. And then she also had 2 bags of these. Have any of you had this before? I don't know. Oh, it's upside down, Mary. I don't know. All I know is it's called fried nori. Nori is seaweed. And it is like the most addictive thing ever. This is my first time ever eating it because Mitch brought it. So it's just seaweed and it has wheat flour, oil, salt, chili pepper, MSG, sugar, and pepper. So it looks like they dip the nori in like this batter and then they fry it real fast. This thing is so addictive. Oh, my shirt's all wet. It's so addictive that I swear to God, it has like 25 or 30 pieces in a bag. But I can eat the whole thing. So there were 2 of these in the bag with this that Mitch dropped off and said, Shelby couldn't take it on the plane, so can you ship it to her? I'm like, yeah, okay. Well, we ate it. I don't like to clean the squid either. Emily, do you watch Bada Namu? Emily, do you watch Bada Namu on YouTube? Bada Namu. I guess not. She doesn't know what that is. Hi, Teresa.
What does that mean?
I think she couldn't take the nori because it couldn't fit in her bag and she didn't want to carry it. It's really good. This fried nori is really good. This Lily Koi butter, I can guarantee you, is really good. I keep pointing it up here because that's where the comments are. See that? Show them your new hat that Daddy got. So we went to Ross to go find a gift for his brother. And he ended up shopping more for himself than his
and
brother.
Me.
Okay, so...
So he
we have
keeps
six,
on buying... Cowboy
oh, the ponytail stuff. The ponytail song by Bada Namu. Go look for it. Go on Daddy's phone. Go look for it. I don't know. It's right there. The ponytail song. They said they like your hair. Go find it, please. Thank you.
Hey.
So for the people that's tuning in now, this is what we're making for dinner. Right here. I used a stack cooker cookbook. And we're making herb potatoes on the top, steak and onions in the middle, and quinoa rice at the bottom. They said nice hat. So I've been going through this. And you know what? My intention was to go live in both Legacy Party Sales and my page. But I totally forgot. So I only went live on my page. And I also was supposed to go live on Instagram. But that's okay. I'll go live when I open everything out. But this is why I recommend this particular product and the recipe book for busy moms like me. Because it gives you ideas on what to make, and you just kind of flip through it. Like, this one has stewed beans. It uses pinto beans, oregano, sofrito, and tomato sauce. Now, I don't know what sofrito is or where I can find it. Most of the recipes you find in here, Cole, they're not all keto. So you're going to have to kind of look at it to get an idea and then MacGyver it so that you remove the carbs from any of the ingredients. But I can tell you, like, we have less than 5 minutes left to check it. I'm pretty sure it's going to need 5 to 6 minutes more. But it smells really good right now. And I don't see any boil overs. So that's a good thing.
Can you open the last bag?
What bag? Of this?
Yeah.
Okay, here. Just go open it and sit over there. Yeah, go. Give it to Mama.
Because Mama wants.
So, like, if you're like me and you just don't know what the heck to make for dinner... this actually has saved me a few times because I'll flip through this and be like, oh, I think I have this and I have that, you know? So like they even have chocolate cake where you can do a chocolate cake on the top. This cookbook is actually available for sale on the website. Butter, flour, cocoa powder, sugar, baking powder, vanilla, coconut oil, and almond milk. So that's what's in the chocolate cake. There's lemon raspberry cake, caramel apple streusel. That sounds yummy. It's extra bright because I have Is that better? Is that better or worse? Better? Worse. The picture looks really good. This one has apples, caramel topping, water, lemon juice, flour, sugar, cinnamon, butter. Pretty simple ingredients. That's for the top. And then, so you flip through it and you don't have to do it stacked. Like if you just want to do one thing, like upside down stuffed peppers, you can just do that. And it doesn't, you know, if you're just doing one level, you don't need to use the middle. You can use the bottom and throw it in there. And it also explains on here, like if you're doing just this by itself, you can cook it separately for 8 to 10 minutes. If you're stack cooking it, you want to do 15 to 20. Check for doneness and then add on minutes as needed, depending on how dense you make it. So I have to admit that this thing has saved me the last couple times that I was trying to figure out dinner, because I'll just flip through it and look at my pantry and go, I think have these. So mashed potatoes, like if you have a lot of potatoes like we do, we need to use it up. We'll be doing a lot of potatoes. Does anybody know, okay, what is polenta? I've never had polenta either. 3 cups water, cornmeal, Parmesan cheese, pepper, and salt. So what's the texture of polenta if it's cornmeal? Because when I think of cornmeal, I think of that gritty stuff at the bottom of pizza crust. Is it kind of like grits? So I've never had polenta before. Easy mac and cheese, elbow macaroni, water, cream, cheese, garlic powder, and salt. Lemon butter pasta. So there's so many different combinations that you can do with this. So you could do different top, bottom, middles. And so they were saying that you have 5,000 different combinations. Ooh, jambalaya. Oh, it's kind of like grits. Is it, Deanna? I've never tried. I'm going to have to try that when I'm not like on this whole going to be on keto life. So I've never had jambalaya in my life either. Tomatoes with green peppers, quick cooking rice, shrimp, a can of chunky style ham. I've never even seen those before. Water and chili powder. So that's the jambalaya. So you could do jambalaya in the middle. You could do your mashed potatoes on the bottom, and you can do a cake on the top. So I've never had jambalaya. Hi, Marie. Yeah, mac and cheese. You can do mac and cheese in the stack cooker. You can also do it in the pressure cooker. So exciting. Bacon, onion, rice. Yum. So one of the things that I noticed about this cookbook is that when it uses rice, it uses quick cooking rice. Now, I don't use quick cooking rice. I use regular rice and I cook it like for the full amount of time that is needed. But maybe you guys know so that I know what product to get. But when it says quick cooking rice, is that Uncle Ben's minute rice? Is that the same thing? Like, I don't want to buy the wrong thing and it goes all haywire. So that's what I'm asking, because it says quick cooking rice. And because of that, I've avoided those particular recipes because I don't have that. So I'm thinking if it says quick cooking rice for me, because I don't have that, I would have to cook the rice in advance and then just mix it in all together. What do you think? Oh, it is minute rice? Okay. That's good to know. So that's the cookbook. It's all glossy paper, so you can easily wipe it down if it gets dirty. So that was 15 minutes. We're going to check it for doneness. So here's the potatoes. Oh my God, it looks done. Okay, wait, hold on. I'm going to adjust the lighting because right now it's really, really bright, okay? So I'm going to put it to normal. It's going to look a little dark. But that's actually what it's supposed to look like. That way there's not so much glare. So here's the potatoes. This was in 15 minutes. I'm going to poke it and check it. Here's the steak with onions. And this part smells really, really good. With the vinegar. Give me your jaw. Who knew? So the steak and onions is done. It's very, very soft. I'm just going to kind of mix it up so it all sits in the liquid. Because it smells really good. It's still a little pink in the middle. If you like it like that, you can leave it like this, or you can keep cooking. The potatoes do, I'm gonna just kind of move the potatoes around. Some of the bigger pieces are still kind of hard, so we're gonna cook this for about 5 more minutes. And then the rice and quinoa stuff is not ready. So 5 minutes for sure I'm gonna need. Let me stir it up. Stir it up. Ooh, it's nice and, you can see it coming along though. So it depends on your microwave wattage, guys. So if you have a 1200 watt microwave, I just use regular steak, Deanna, and I just cut them in cubes like that. So I'm going to put this all back in, and we're going to put it in for 5 minutes. I use an 1100-watt microwave, and everything is trial and error, guys. So I've never made this particular stack before, so I'm learning as I go with you. If you have an 1100-watt, you would probably do it 20 to 25 minutes. If you have a higher-powered microwave, what I would recommend you do is lower the power and then cook it for the same duration. And the reason I say that is because if you have such a strong microwave, you have a higher chance of like possibly melting the Tupperware, because our products are made actually for 900 watt microwave. So if it's a very powerful one, you don't want to damage your Tupperware, and you also don't want to burn your food, because it's kind of hard to, you can't really control power when you're cooking in a microwave. It just cooks it at that heat and it just keeps going, you know what I mean? So you might want to adjust your power and power it down a little bit. And if I was not doing a live, I'd probably be catching up on my 90 Day Fiance. So have you guys been watching that show? I'm trying to catch up on the last tell-all one, because that one seemed to be pretty heated. And I've also been watching the reruns of Surviving R. Kelly. Have you guys been watching that show? Oh my God. It comes on every night late at night, and it just replays over and over the different episodes. And every night I'm catching a different one. So I'm trying to like put it all together. But, you know, I was watching that, and then like any other person who's curious, I was looking up the ex-wife. I think her name is Drea. I was looking her up and just kind of looking and seeing all that stuff. I didn't watch last night's call, so I'm trying to catch up and watch it now, and then I had to get up and start cooking, so I gotta catch up. Somebody was showing it live from their TV. Wait, so you guys don't have Lifetime Channel? The Surviving R. Kelly show? But I was looking up the people that was on it, right, for Surviving R. Kelly, and I have to remind myself that it is TV, so you're not gonna see the whole full perspective of the whole, right? You're only hearing what they want to show. But I felt really bad for all of those girls that were violated, and the ex-wife that was abused, all of that stuff, right? It's just like horrible what they had to go through. And then I go on social media, and I see a different angle of them. Mind you, we can't tell when it was recorded, when they did it, but it's just like it kind of just screams a different picture. So it's like, I don't know what's going on, and I don't know what people are feeling, but it's just really sad. Like, I see the parents and how they want to try and get their daughters back, and the daughters aren't coming to the door. Did you guys see that one? I just felt really bad for the mom and dad, because they just wanted to see their daughter, and she wouldn't come to the door, and they were banging on the door and throwing rocks at the window. So I was watching that. Me and Paca were talking about it last night. Paca has been working a lot, so he hasn't been online much, and I don't think he's going to pop on this one, too. You saw it when you were scrolling through. Yeah. Hi, Tracy. Long time no see. So, I just want to think of things to talk about, because I had so much stuff going on in my mind. Oh, it started and it stopped. So, you know, we had our annual recognition for the whole year, right? Like, this was what part of our training was about on the weekend. So our business leader put together this denim and diamonds theme party, or training party. And so she pulled all the data for the full year and then recognized all of the tops. And so I thought everything was done after like Jubilee. Hi, Melissa. I thought it was all done, but I keep forgetting that Jubilee is literally half the year. So the second half, it's not the whole year. So I was very shocked to see that I got number one in like personal sales and all that stuff, because I, in my mind, felt like I could have done more, you know, like, so I was pretty shocked at that. I honestly thought other people were going to get those spots, but I was very, very happy and honored to receive those awards, like mind blown, really. And so now I've set new goals for myself, new goals to where I want to get my team to by the end of this year, as well as by July, the end of July. And the reason is, all of the stats that get pulled in from now until the end of July is what you get recognized for at Jubilee in August, which is what I shared with you guys last August, which was such a amazing event. And so one of my goals is to be back up on that stage to get another crown and a sash, because that was such an amazing feeling. And so I'm really hoping that I can help groom this team and everything to get there. So I've been changing things up with what I've been doing with my team. So I'll be doing monthly team meetings at my house with them, and just sharing and picking the brains of some of the top directors across the U.S. that I have made friends with in the last year. Oh, yeah, this is done. The potatoes are done. It just needs to rest, but it's fork tender. So here's the potatoes with the herb, the oregano and the onion salt. And then here's the steak. The rice is still boiling, so the steak is all done. And then let me stir this up. This is the rice with the grains. This part still needs a little bit more boiling. And the reason is the energy has to be shared with the steak and the potatoes. So the rice is not getting all the attention. So I'm going to put the rice back in for maybe another 7 minutes, because I want it to be nice and soft and fluffy. So really it takes a total of 30 minutes altogether. So this part is done. I'm going to let it rest. The steak and the onions are done, and I'm going to let that rest. And I'm going to rest it like this. And then the rice is last. And then that one is done. So yay, dinner is all done. How long have I been on? Wow, 45 minutes. Didn't feel like that long when I'm talking story with you guys. So thank you for sticking with me. It's been a while since I did one this long, y'all. Keep it up and I'll be upgrading. That was my goal for last year. And what I've learned about the What's Your Drive, because Paula, you're a consultant too, right? So what I learned about the car program is, like, I earned the car at the end of December of 2017. And then what happens is, for us in Hawaii, it takes 6 months for the car to get here. So in those 6 months, because the car is not here, they give you the cash option until the car arrives. However, they don't count the sales towards the next car until you actually take possession of the car. So do you get what I mean? So the first 6 months of 2018, none of those sales counted to help me earn the next level up. So I lost all those sales towards the next car, which I feel is, like, to me, it's just, I don't feel like it's fair, especially because, like, we have to wait 6 months here in Hawaii, but the mainland has, like, some of them get it in a month, 2-3 months. So they just lose out 3 months of those sales. If they were to count it, because they're giving me the cash option, so either way, it's like I have the car, right? But this is just my opinion, and this is just my thoughts on it. I'm talking, Emily. If they had counted the sales from January through the end of December, I would have earned the Traverse, because I earned the car at the end of December. All of the sales from January to December, if that would have counted, I would have earned the Traverse, but I didn't. So my goal right now is to help get my sales and my team sales up to about 30,000 every month from now until May, and then I'll earn the car. So I have to, like, really pick up some steam starting now if I want to get that car. I'm not sure what happens if I don't hit it by May. 20 years ago. Oh, you prep everything in advance in the stack cooker. Oh, I gotcha. Gotcha. You know what? I was thinking about just doing regular rice, but when you cook regular rice in the stack cooker, it cooks best without anything on top of it, because the starchiness boils up. So if I were to do rice in this, I probably would do the steak at the bottom, the rice in the middle with no potatoes, so that it has space to boil. But that's a good one. If I prepped it in advance and I just soaked it, it would have been really good. Hi, Sharon. Hi, Sherry. Sherry is like a VIP customer. She always helps me with trying to hit my goals. So I really appreciate Sherry a lot. Romel is watching, so if you guys want to say hi to him, he's there. Hi, Jennifer. Hi, Ashley. So almost pow. Once this is all done, I'm going to log off of here and I'll pop onto Instagram real fast to show people what I made. 3 to 4 minutes. Oh, bye, Cole. Thank you for watching today. What else is there? Have any of you seen any of the new products that they brought out? And which one of those are your fave? I haven't looked at my survey answers yet, so thank you to those of you that filled out my survey. I wanted to ask questions about what your ideas were of having a party. Because one of my goals this year is to do more in-home parties. I've been focused a lot in the last 2 years on doing online parties. And that has worked out very well for me. But I really miss that personal interaction with people and being able to actually be in a room with people and just that whole socializing the old school way. I really do miss that part of it. And so I really want to focus on doing the in-home party in 2019. Not to say I'm not going to do online parties, because online parties are fun too. But I really want to take it back to the in-home party, and that will allow me to be able to do more training parties for my team to help get them started. I'm going to try the potato. Oh my god, it's good. Right, Paula? 2 months. That's what I'm thinking, is 2 months, not six. So I lost half a year of sales to earn the next car up. So that's why I was like, I don't know how fair this is to us out here. And I didn't learn this until I took possession of the car. So before the car came, I was tracking all my sales because I was already focused on earning the next car up. And then when the car came and I checked the tracker thing and it went down to zero, I'm like, what's going on here? Like, how come it's not counting all my sales? But you can't really fight the system. These potatoes are really good, you guys. Mmm. Oh my god, I love potatoes. So when I do an in-home party, I always do a Tupper Connect, Paula, and I don't really do the online part. I'll share some things in there. But I've been doing more just online parties, and it's the desire and the demand for that is there, but I want to go back to doing in-home parties. I haven't done an in-home party in quite some time. I think the last one I did was last month with one of my girlfriends, and it was fun, and I got to, you know, hang out with them, and I just missed that part of it. And so I'm really looking for someone who is here locally that wants to do an in-home party. And it doesn't even have to be like a formal party. It can just be a get-together so that I can get back in the routine of party prepping and host coaching and all that stuff for the in-home party, because it's a little different when you're doing an online one. Yeah, use the Power Chef to make baby food. Isn't it awesome? I don't miss making baby food, but it comes in very, very handy. Oh, and Desiree, I have not shown my mom pictures of the houses yet. I'm gonna show her that after I get off the live. Hi, Noemi. Yeah, so hi, Samantha. So that's my goal this year, is to do in-home. So if anybody is watching that's here on Oahu and has been thinking about doing some kind of get-together, I'm looking for someone to start me off this year. And I wanted to do it with somebody who I've never done it with, because that makes it more fun, you know? I'm going to eat all these potatoes. Oh, yeah, this is good. Ta-da!
There it is.
Nobody's moving. Romel's like trolling all the comments. Yep, this is done. It just needs resting time and it'll get nice and soft. So this was just the 1.5 cups of rice with 3 cups of, 2.5 cups of broth, 1/2 cup of water, and a pinch of salt. So dinner is finally done. Yay. I know I was on for almost an hour. But had I not did the live, I probably would have been in the kitchen for maybe 15, 20 minutes tops. Yeah. Okay, so everything is done. I'm going to log off. I will see you guys tomorrow. I'm going to be busy tomorrow all day. So I'm not going to be cooking live tomorrow, because after I'm done my project, I have to go straight to Rally. But I will be on Wednesday night. I think we have Lions Club meeting, so we're gonna see about that.
Mom,
so
what did you cook?
I made steak, potatoes, and quinoa rice. She's not sure if she likes it. Okay, I'll see you guys later. Say bye. We're gonna log off. Bye, everybody. See you.